Hey there, guys, and welcome back to our third installment of Subnautica.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Hi there, Friday. My name is Pagan, and we are gonna go for a ride today. I don't know what we're gonna do yet, but I love that we can charge our batteries. Woohoo! Okay, so we can get away with a whole lot of our lead and our titanium. We need something more, don't we? So pick up some glass. Let's see if we can construct another locker. Awesome. Oh, wait. What happened? There. I think I turned it around. Way too much. More than I ought to have. I like the flare, but we need to keep that. We need to keep that around. Okay, let's keep all of our titanium in one place. There we go. One of the things I want to construct this way is a modification station. We need a wiring kit, computer chip, and some titanium. Okay, I have some idea of what we need for that. So we're just gonna head out and get the rest of it. So we have lithium now. Lithium is interesting because right now our base strength is at whatever it is, and we can reinforce it by using lithium. That means when we expand plus 14 to base hull strength. That means when we expand our base, which we are going to do a whole lot, this place is going to be big when we reach Fern series. It means we're not going to start to sink and take on water. So, let's see if we can't find some coral. Where's our knife? There we go. Red table coral. Red table coral. There we go. That's all we need of that. Now we need silver. Copper. Yay, we can use copper. Okay, we are gonna venture out. Yeah, let's just grab some quartz and hope these things don't bite us. Titanium. We need something more exotic. We need 3 pieces of silver. Okay, we found copper. Ah! Darn it. That is the sound they make when they... Okay, yeah, when we're gaining on their territory, right? Shoot, swim the other way. Maybe we'll be faster that way. Yay, save me! Neat. Oh, sand shark, we're moving in on a whole lot of dangerous territory here. Oh, I don't like that shadow. That shadow looks like it just consumed our shadow. Oh, shoot, shoot, it's still on us. It's on our tail. Okay, get up. Get up! We spent way too much time down here. Let's head down. One of the upgrades we're gonna do once we have a modification station is be able to expand our air tank. So we gain, I don't know, something in the lines of 40 seconds more. Which is great. That's just awesome. Oh, gold. Yay, we don't need gold just yet.
Calorie intake recommended.
Calorie intakes. Not sufficient. Spadey! Let's bait fish this up. Is that what I'm looking for? Yes, silver ore. Can we get one more before we go up? Yes, yes we can. I can hear reef bags in the distance. That's the last that we needed. We're just gonna head home right now. When we are at deeper sea levels, we consume oxygen faster. So at one point we're gonna craft a special helmet that allows us to reuse some of our air. It's called a rebreather and it is really handy. Let's see about it. I love these coral tubes, they look so good. This game is gorgeous. The graphics are so pretty, and you just feel space in front of you when light moves through it like that, and when all the algae and particles just soar in front of you. Besides, just look at the lighting effects. They are gorgeous. Plus, our bases look so high tech. Even the destroyed spaceship looks super neat. That's just a nice accomplishment. These guys are almost back to full. That is so cool. Now we can just use our Sea Glide all the time. So cool. Okay, glass, maybe at one point, but we're gonna start off with a computer chip and a wiring kit. And that's just gonna get into our inventory. Yes, it is. So, let's make something interesting. We are going to make the modification station. Let it be somewhere out here. There we go. Cool. Oh, that looks cool. Air tank. Extra light tank. I'm not sure that actually has any function in the game yet. It might have. But right now, it's supposed to be extra light. But right now, our O2 tank doesn't weigh anything. Oh, that's actually it. So we're just gonna put our O2 tank there. And extra air capacity. How much are we gonna get? Oh, nice. 30 more than what we had. That's really cool. Cooked food. Cooked peeper. Protein-rich eyeballs. Ugh. Small bones at texture. Wow. Starting to feel like a seafood restaurant. Good eating around the cartilaginous fins. Huh. Let's look at the view while we're eating. Cooked peeper.
Vital signs stabilizing.
Yeah, I guess we have been putting that off. But there was so much to do in the last episode. Oh, we actually need some water at some point. Wait. Haven't I stored a few fish at some point? Yes, I did. We have a bunch of air sacs from when we did the Riddick challenge with the flares underwater. Which was super funny. It looked so good, everything covered in red. We're just gonna take this one, and this one. They're almost at 99%, all of them. Cool. What else can we upgrade for this? Our fins can become ultra glide fins. So increased swim speeds. We could definitely use that too, couldn't we? Oh, the propulsion cannon becomes a repulsion cannon. Applies force to objects. What does the propulsion cannon do in the first place? We're gonna need that. Oh, but first, this is a heated thermal blade. Oh, we are going to need that. I don't care if we sacrifice a single battery on that. Because, let's find a fish somewhere. There are no fish in this ocean. Man. Boomerangs, faster than they used to be. But not so much. There. Cooked boomerang. Straight from the ocean. Oh, that's just nice. So if we're out exploring and we desperately need something to eat, that's just one way to get it. Okay, so to make the ultra glide fins, we need... There. We need silicone rubber, which we are gonna get from the plankton out here. Not the plankton, but the kelp. The giant kelp ones. Whoop. Oh, and now we got this growing for us again. We got speed and we got durability. So cool. Can we even carry more? Not from that one. There we go. 7. Cool. That's all we needed. And I think we even have some to spare now. Nighttime approaches. Ooh, look, the first stars are out. When I say the first stars, I mean almost all of them. So cool. That looks so huge. And it moves across the sky so very fast. And it looks very intimidating through just below the surface. We should definitely expand our home in this one. I mean, we may not need the space right now. But let's be honest, it's a cool thing to do. So, the fins, yeah, we need the silicone rubber first. silicone rubbers. There, it just takes two from the creep line. Nice, very nice. So let's put the rest of the creep line here. And just make the ultra glide fins. Oh, cool. So this is just us swimming now without the sea glide. We are so much faster than we kicked off the series. Now, let's start constructing some interesting vessels. For that matter, let's expand the home for now. Let's make this bigger. We could use some space to stretch ourselves in. So, let's expand. We could expand in that direction. That could be neat too. We need to break apart some of that if we want to go that way. But there's so much room out here. I am going to remove the hatch from this side and extend this entire part with a corridor. There we go. See how the base hull strength in the upper left corner just went down? That's why we needed some of the lithium. Cool. We are making air and connecting another room. There we are. Ugh, so sleek. Nice. Very, very nice. Okay. To make something more interesting in this game, we are gonna have to construct one of the deployables, which is a mobile vehicle. That way we can actually make our mini sub. Grass sphere. Current generator. Oh, there are so many cool things. So we need the lubricant, which we can get out of these, which we just found the other way. We still have some power left, but it's becoming dawn now, so we don't have to worry about power. Okay. Titanium ingot, that means we need 10 titanium pieces, and we need to forge it into an ingot, sort of like a gold bar. And we need a power cell. If I remember correctly, a power cell can be crafted out of two batteries and one piece of silicone rubber. So we need to go hunt down for the silicone rubber and the titanium. I love how they made schools of fish just appear everywhere. It's such a nice extra feature. Oh, pick up a hoverfish? Yes. Here, creep vine. Just take everything we can get. Oh, inventory's full now. Is that true? No, we still have three spaces left. Can't we pick up some more or something?
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
We're gonna be fine now. Everything's okay. Everything was okay. Oh! Goodness, they're everywhere. I am gonna look forward to having some more protection from that of a mini sub. Just like how I wouldn't delve into shark filled waters without a cage. I would definitely want some more protection. Lubricant. Okay, we need the lubricant and we need a titanium ingot. So the lubricant, I made that by mistake, but we can actually use it for something later on. There. Let's make a power cell. So we do have a power cell and we do have lubricant. We even have some extra lubricant. Now we need 10 titanium, so I'm gonna go off and hunt for that. And I'll see you guys in a bit.
Ah!
Go away, go away! I was trying to scan the sea glide fragment to get the titanium from it, and then this guy attacked me. Ah, shoot! God, there are many! Get out of my way!
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
We're gonna be fine, Friday. Don't you even worry about it. Ooh, look. There's a creature egg. Let's pick it up. We can actually make aquariums if we want. We don't have to, but in the recent update you can make giant, and I do mean giant, aquariums that can fill entire, in, for that matter, several floors of these the big old modules. The creature eggs will slowly hatch once you place them in one of the giant aquariums. And it's fun and it's pretty, and we totally need to do that just for the simple fact that we can. So, we have a bunch of titanium now. There, now we have enough to make a titanium ingot. So, let's pick up our power cell and our lubricant. And let us make a mobile vehicle bay. Ooh, that is sweet. This is gonna be sweet. Release the vehicle bay. And we release it by assigning it to one of these. And go. I love how it comes as a briefcase. And then it just folds out like this. Oh, that's super nice. These drones are kind of constructed, just like we can construct with this thing. They can do it a whole lot faster with a whole lot of things that are bigger. So we need another titanium ingot, which is great because we brought a lot of extra titanium. And a new power cell. Ugh, we need so many power cells. We need 2x glass and we need lubricant. Oh, so we could actually use the lubricant we just found. Oh, that's nice. Man, I am really looking forward to in something coming up next week. I have ordered some new microphone audio materials from England, and they're gonna arrive not far from now. That means audio quality is going to go way up when I'm blabbering as much as I am. So I'm really looking forward to that. Okay, silicone rubber. Let's go make ourselves a new ride. Power cell. Wasn't that it? Climb. Hey guys. Oh, you're super nice. Oh, wait, really? I don't have a lubricant with me? You gotta have that lubricant on you. I mean, it's so essential. The game told us. Life told us no, it didn't.
Caution. Mild dehydration detected. Fluid intake recommended.
I think we're gonna be alright. Oh, look at this. Look at the beauty that is happening before us. Oh my god, let's go christen it. Oh my god, we have a base and we have a Seamoth. You are beautiful. Should we name our Seamoth? We could. At one point we can actually spell something out on the side of it.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Oh, Friday has gotten a whole lot more computerized when it's in our Seamoth. Look how fast it is. Nice. So nice. Wow. That is very, very cool. Now that we actually have the Seamoth, that means we can go a lot deeper into the oceans, and we can do some very, 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 well, we can visit some very interesting areas. If you've noticed, whenever we get near the aurora, this happens. we take radiation damage. So we were at 71% health, and now we're all the way down to 60. So what we need to construct to be able to survive the radiation that's leaking from that monstrosity over there is a new suit of armor. Constructing poor innocent creatures into nourishment. The future's epic. You can just bring a cow into one of the laser scanner fabricator thingamajinks and you just get ground beef right there. That is horrible and fun. We need fiber mesh and we need lead. Here we are. With our thermal blade. That heats up bubbles and everything. There we go. Oh, we actually unlocked the dive reel, the rebreather, and fiber mesh just by collecting this. Oop. Yeah. Our love burned too hot and bright.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Thank you, Friday. How have you been doing? Are you having a good day, night? Do you sleep? Are you alive? My own personal Siri. I think that's awesome. Fiber mesh. Strong natural fiber, and it's comfy. Oh wait, comfy. This is one of the things that we can make a bed out of later on. We can make a kelp bed. Oh, that is gonna be cool. That way we can also sleep through the night, so we can pretty much be day all the time. And that just would be such a cool addition. Plus, we could just dedicate an entire room for that. Just a sleeping area. Ooh, that's where we gotta build our aquarium. There we go, this home is practically building itself. And I kind of mean that. There, radiation suit, radiation helmet, and some radiation gloves. There we are, all lead-based, and now we are impervious to any kind of radiation. We can, on the other hand, get other suits that allow for some other upgrades. So we don't really want radiation leaked in it to our ocean. So what we can do is go over to the Aurora and try to fix up the giant radiation spill that's coming from one of the generators. Which I kind of think we ought to do in this episode. That would be a fairly nice expedition. I was getting a health kit for our dude and I just noticed there was a new message at the comm terminal.
Playing message. This is an automated distress signal from Aurora Lifebot 17.
Oh.
Coordinates attached. Please send immediate emergency relief team.
Oh, there are other lifebots out there. There are other lifebots out there. We might not be alone on this planet. There might be others. That's very cool. We have to look for those guys. We're just gonna head there now. We're gonna turn on our light. It might use a little more energy, but we don't need that much energy for now. Ooh, look. From the Aurora, there are a lot of fun things around. And they drop tiny caches, just like this. Supply crates. What do you know? Disinfected water. Preparing the day's water ration ahead of time will help ensure against dehydration and eventual death. God, cheer up, Friday. Oh, wow. This kind of water is gives us more O2 than the other ones. And it can be used for more interesting things. Ooh, sand sharks are abound. But you can't really touch us now, can you? You don't even register us as food. Oh! Bump! Okay. They're still somewhat hostile. Let's see if this supply crate guns something interesting. Whoa, this is interesting. This is a signal. And it points towards somewhere way over there near our home. But it seems deeper into the ground. Possible cave openings and heat signatures all around.
Welcome
that is cool.
Captain.
So that just points to points of interest around the world. Like places with unique features or technology that we can't find anywhere else. We want those. Okay, that is a scary sound. Oh, this place doesn't feel stable. My entire screen. The camera really shakes around right now. Things sound mean around here. Oh, tiny crab creatures are just falling down. Huh. I guess they've taken up residence around here. Is this where we can just get off and move on to the ship?
Wow.
Warning, structural integrity unknown. Exploration is not advised. Yeah, like I said, this is turning out to be a really bad idea. But we are above water, and that's always funny. Oh, medkits. Ah, we're gonna be fine. Can I scan you guys? Cave crawlers! you're outside of your habitat. Did you know that? They don't look friendly. Well, they look like the facehuggers from Half-Life. And they try to greet me in about the same way. Face first.
Whoa.
Man, this is looking fierce. Oh, ah, shoot! Get away! Ow! Man, we just got sparks on our head.
Trace human remains detected in nearby organics digestive systems. Further exploration not advised. No, I guess why. I think our crew got eaten.
How do we even progress? Oh, I think we have to cross this here. Some of the textures aren't the best, but they've really made this place, well, I'd say shine. They've destroyed this place a whole lot more since first I checked. Oh look, there's a power cell. Ah! Let's get away from all the sparks. Ow, 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 ow. The shiny things are not our friends.
Ooh, shiny.
Oh man. This place does not seem like it's durable. No signal. Pressure compensator. 87% of habitable sections of ships were rendered uninhabitable during the crash. Oh, a pressure compensator. Is that for... that's for Seamoth. Hardens the vehicle chassis under high pressures. Oh, that's cool. So we can actually take our Seamoth and dive deeper. So we can delve deeper into the oceans. That's very cool. Huh, it's already worth coming over here. Assessing internal damage. Damage pattern inconsistent with internal malfunction. Aurora black box device not found. So maybe one of the other survivors took him with her. Or it was, well, like a lot of parts of the ship damaged. Checking drive core damage against Aurora impact velocity. Calculations suggest collision was of insufficient magnitude to cause a core breach. Then what caused the core breach? Did aliens sabotage us? Ooh, look at that smoke. Woof. We have a laser cutter and there's our welder. Oh, look, the Cyclops. Cyclops power efficiency module. Nice. And we haven't built the Cyclops yet, which is one of the giant submarines. Which actually just functions as a movable base. Okay. Nine radiation leaks more. So we're just gonna poke around and see if we can't find a few more of these. There's the last one. Let's see what happens when we finally can. Maybe we can steer the ship and power it back up. Drive core breach sealed. Radiation dissipation in 3 days.
High energy particle containment field restored. Auto decontamination sequence initiated. Aquatic radiation levels are estimated to return to safe levels in T-minus 3 days, 10 hours.
3 days and 10 hours. Then we can actually take this radiation suit off and just be on our merry way. That is really cool. Sweet. Because I want some of the other suits. Some of the suits provide armor and some pick up water and distill it just as you swim through the water. I mean, that's some advantages we are going to want. We are traversing these oceans here. Such a nice game. I would love to see them finish an area called the Lost River. The Lost River expansion. Which is a whole new area that they're setting up for us. Let's head home! Now we are gonna go hang out with some reefbacks. You guys are just plain awesome. So we got an upgrade for our Seamoth, so we can access these upgrades and we can install some of them. Here, crush depth now at 300 meters, so our Seamoth can get down to all 300 meters below the surface. Oh, that is cool. Oh, that is awesome. Oh, now we can actually go explore some of the cooler caves and the deep areas. Speaking of which, let's see if we can find some cool areas down here. This here is the Mushroom Forest. Awesome. Now this is really cool. Look, these are jelly rays. I think that they are harmless. They were in the last few editions of the game. Ooh. And now they just look like a creature from Deep Blue when you're scanning them. Jelly rays. Well, they look friendly enough. Oh, that's one of the moons up there. Such a cool area. I do believe that at one point we can actually use these things, right? Oh my god!
Caution, calorie deficiency.
I killed a giant mushroom. Oh, fungal samples. And I swear to god, I cannot remember what I'm supposed to be using them for. Now this is kind of cool. I think there's a type of creature egg down here. Isn't it? Inventory full. What is that? I want that. It is a creature egg, isn't it? It could be so cool to have an aquarium with one of these jelly rays in it. Cool. We are at full carrying capacity, so we're just gonna head home. Guys, I think we are gonna call this episode for today. I'm looking forward to having you again. Cause this, woo-hoo-hoo-hoo, it's a blast. You guys take care. Bye now.
Hi there, guys. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye now.